welcome to a smoking hot edition of Velocity. It should be outstanding, and look who's here.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. Approaching the ring from Toronto, Ontario, weighing in at 224 pounds, Christian.
Tremendous card on tap for the Great American Bash. One more feature on the card is Christian taking on Booker T. That has got to be on his mind.
Of course it's on his mind, Steve Romero. Christian knows that the Great American Bash, he will go one-on-one with Booker T. And this time, Booker T will be ready for any shenanigans by Captain Charisma.
No doubt there.
And from Japan, weighing in at 108 pounds, Funaki.
Well, Funaki will be taking on Christian, and perhaps an opportunity for Funaki if Christian is looking too far ahead, Josh.
Well, I had the opportunity to speak to Christian this past week on SmackDown, and not only did he call me Ryan Seacrest, but Christian seems pretty confident heading into the Great American Bash that he is going to defeat Booker T.
And I think Christian brought that swagger over from Raw and quite confident over here on SmackDown and looking to be one of the top stars.
Well, Christian has brought all the peeps over to SmackDown. Whenever Christian is in the house, all the peeps are here.
And as you look at the crowd, you can tell they're here to support him. Quite a few signs.
It's too bad Christian won't let you be one of his peeps, Steve Romero.
You know, I guess it's an exclusive list. I'm not invited.
But you are invited to the Great American Bash. I'll be there. The Great American Bash is going to be absolutely off the chain.
What a tremendous card. And as we said, Christian and Booker T, and they... Oh, look at Funaki with the schoolboy real quick getting a two count, and perhaps Captain Charisma enjoying himself too much.
Well, like you said, Christian, maybe looking towards the Great American Bash, maybe looking towards Booker T, and Christian perhaps forgetting about Funaki. Funaki maybe able to steal a victory here.
Funaki off the ropes and misses, rolls out of the ring. Christian had on his mind exactly what Funaki was going to do there.
Booker T looking absolutely impressive this past week on SmackDown against Simon Dean, one of my favorite WWE superstars. But Booker T made quick work of Simon Dean.
And Simon Dean's one of those guys that grows on it.
I love him.
Christian helping Funaki back into the ring. Funaki right now holding those lower left ribs, that rib cage. We'll see how that progresses throughout the match. Christian saw that and continues to take advantage. And that right there won't help any at all, Josh, that abdominal stretch.
Obviously, Christian will have a different game plan at the Great American Bash against Booker T. Booker T has a size advantage over Christian, and Booker also has those long limbs, those long arms, and those long legs. It'll be tough for Christian to get Booker in holds like this.
The last time they faced each other, Josh, Christian perhaps taking a few cheap shots, catching Booker T off guard, making quick work of the bookman. And Booker will not forget that, has not forgotten that.
Christian, he got a cheap victory over Booker T. He jumped Booker T before the match, and he stole a victory from the bookman. The bookman looking for retribution at the Great American Bash. And in my opinion, he's going to get it.
And Funaki looking for some great things to happen. The Bulldog to Christian, both superstars down on the canvas. Funaki trying to get to those ropes and help himself up. But again, those ribs becoming a problem, Josh. And you've been in the ring. You know what it's like to have those ribs stung.
When your ribs get busted up, they could be cracked, they could be broken. It's tough to breathe. It's tough to get deep breaths. And you need those deep breaths when you're inside the ring.
Oh, Funaki digs deep. That head scissors throws Christian for a loop. Hey, how about the most anticipated match on the card? JBL, who won the WWE title a year ago at the Great American Bash, trying to claim the world championship from the Animal Batista.
I thought when you said most anticipated match, I thought you were talking about the broad panties match.
Oh, well, you know, cover here by Funaki, the count to two. Christian able to get that left shoulder up. But I digress.
Getting back to that World Heavyweight Championship match, I can't wait to see it. The first time ever, JBL versus Batista. Batista defending his title for the first time since coming to SmackDown. It is going to be awesome.
Funaki off the ropes, has Christian on his back with that crossbody, gets the count to two. Awesome is a great word for it. 600 pounds of tremendous talent in the ring. Speaking of JBL and Batista, that is, not Funaki.
I thought you were talking about Torrey Wilson and Molina.
Oh, that's just fine. That's the only word I got for that, just fine.
Nothing better than a bra and panty.
Uh-oh, here it is, the unprettier. And Christian hits it on Funaki, and that may be it. And it is.
Here is your winner, Christian.
Well, Josh, Christian tunes up with a victory over Funaki. Next up, Booker T.
We'll find out if Booker T will be the victim of the next Unprettier at the Great American Bash.
Still to come on Velocity, JBL throws himself an early victory celebration. How obnoxious. And the Animal, Batista, decides to crash the party.
But up next, Rey Mysterio versus Super Crazy of the Mexicools. And Eddie Guerrero makes an unexpected appearance.
Just days before Rey has to fight to keep his family secret, Mysterio was in action against one of the Mexicools, Super Crazy. And Eddie Guerrero was ringside for Rey's match.
Rey Mysterio showed a ton of intestinal fortitude here. And Eddie, let's get to the match. You know Rey Mysterio in between the ropes. You know what you got to deal with him.
Oh, I know him better than anyone.
I know you do, and he knows you just as well. He's a tough, tough dude, and you know it. You got to give him that much.
He's got to find out how tough I am. Because there ain't nobody tougher than me.
I'm not doubting your in-ring ability. I've been in the ring with you. I know what you can do, and I know what Rey can do. And that's what makes it such a great match. I just wish this other stuff wasn't involved with it. That's my opinion.
Look at this. Well, Mysterio.
Eddie's already doing that.
He's probably going to get involved here.
Oh, come on now with the damn rake.
Watch out.
Oh, yeah. The back of Mysterio breaking the rake in half in front of the referee. That was his whole damn reason, Cole, had to be out here. To ambush Mysterio.
Well, it sure as hell wasn't answering any questions.
No, he was. He was dodging him. He didn't dodge that rake across the upper spine of Rey Mysterio.
Eddie Guerrero's intention was to come out here and try and injure Rey Mysterio to send a message before the match at the Great American Bash on Sunday.
After his attack on Rey, Eddie started to make his way out of the arena, but Eddie's night was far from over.
You've got a match tonight, player.
A match? No, Teddy. See, I can't wrestle a match. All my gear, it's in the car.
Hey.
Okay?
Hey,
I didn't bring
Eddie,
my gear. I'm not ready.
I don't want to hear it, player. So I suggest to you that you go to the car and get your gear. You got a match tonight.
A match? I ain't going to wrestle a match. Besides, who's this match against anyway?
Now that's a secret, player.
We'll have Eddie's match when we come back.
As you saw before the break, Theodore Long had arranged for Eddie Guerrero to have a match against a mystery opponent. When Eddie got into the ring, he found out he would be facing an old friend, Chris Benoit.
Now Benoit says it's over. Chris Benoit to the apron again. Chris Benoit going to climb the ropes again.
Yeah, he better hope he hits this one. Benoit's on tippy top here. Here he goes.
Benoit connecting.
He got it.
But Benoit may have done damage to himself as well.
Again, Benoit has been busted open in this match from his headbutts earlier.
Chris Benoit.
He's got it.
Rolling
He's got him.
Here's the shoulders down. There's two. And then he got his foot on the bottom rope.
I noticed that coming near the ropes. And that's that, you know, again, say what you want about Guerrero. He's got great match sense, ring presence, knows where he is at all times.
Eddie trying to fight out. He does with a boot to the sternum. Chris Benoit again on the attack.
He don't want Benoit on him. He knows to keep him off.
Look at Benoit right back again.
He's relentless, Cole. Oh, my God. You see the height? The power of pulling Guerrero off those ropes.
Chris Benoit, did you do it? Oh, here we go.
Here we go. Sharpshooter.
Time for the sharpshooter. And he's trying to swim his way out. He rolls up.
Reverse the
reversal. Shoulders down.
Push down.
He got it. He got it. No, two count. A two count. It is him.
Oh, boy. Go for these three amigos. That's one soup, one vertical. There's a second.
And he's looking to connect for a third time here. Benoit counter.
Crossface. Go for that crossbar to that crossface.
Can Benoit get it locked in?
He's trying to, he's got to extend that elbow.
Trying to spread the arm.
He's got to extend that elbow and get those legs over that arm.
Eddie Guerrero fighting
there it is. He's going to get it. He's going to cross. He's going to get it.
Benoit's got it in. Eddie Guerrero makes it to the bottom rope.
Again, out of a submission. Guerrero uses the ropes as his ally to break the hold.
And Eddie Guerrero going to take a breather. And
take a breather? Well, where's he? Where
the hell is Eddie going?
He's doing more than taking a breather.
Eddie's not walking out of this, is he?
I think he's going to hit the shadows. Where's he going here?
Well, maybe not. No. Referee Nick Patrick going to count a six. Eddie said, no way.
He's bailing.
Eddie's had enough.
Are you kidding me or what?
This one's over. Benoit wins via countout. Look at this.
What the hell?
It's Mysterio. Rey Mysterio from behind. Attacking Guerrero.
Oh, God, he deserves it. Payback. Let him go. Payback. Wow.
Rey Mysterio from out of nowhere attacking Eddie Guerrero.
Guerrero on his hands and knees crawling. Falling out of this arena.
I tell you, it's desperation time for Rey Mysterio. Someday at the finish.
Rey Mysterio getting just a taste of the payback he's been looking for.
For the past few weeks, Eddie Guerrero has been torturing Rey Mysterio, holding this secret above Rey's head. But at the Great American Bash, it will all come to a head. If Rey Mysterio wins, Eddie will put this secret to rest forever. But if Eddie is able to pull off a victory, Eddie Guerrero will expose Rey Mysterio's secret at the Great American Bash for the entire world to hear.
Also, one of these superstars will leave the Bash with a chance to become World Heavyweight Champion.
That's right, Muhammad Hassan and the Phenom The Undertaker will battle it out to prove who is worthy of a championship opportunity.
Plus, WWE Tag Team titles will also be on the line at the Great American Bash.
The newly formed team of Road Warrior Animal and Heidenreich will be looking to put an end to M&M's championship reign.
And the Mexicools will be answering a challenge at the Great American Bash.
This past week on WWE.com, the BWO challenged the Mexicools to a six-man tag team match, and the Mexicools have accepted. Who knows what to expect when these six superstars get in the ring?
Plus, Captain Charisma will go one-on-one with the five-time champion, Booker T.
Ever since coming to SmackDown, Christian has been trash-talking about being the biggest star in the locker room, and at the Great American Bash, it's put-up-or-shut-up time when Christian takes on Booker T.
And the hottest match on the card, I mean smoking hot, a bra and panties match between Torrey Wilson and Melina.
This is my kind of match. Torrey and Melina, two of SmackDown's hottest divas, looking to prove who is the most dominant diva on SmackDown. Oh, and by the way, Candice Michelle will be the special guest referee.
Also at the Great American Bash, the United States title will be on the line.
Orlando Jordan has never been tested like he will be tested at the Great American Bash against the best technical wrestler in the business, Chris Benoit.
And of course, the Animal, Batista, will defend the World Heavyweight Championship at the Great American Bash.
Well, last year at the Great American Bash, JBL began his record-setting WWE Championship reign. Will history repeat itself when JBL challenges Batista for the World Heavyweight Championship at this year's Great American Bash?
Well, how about this? The BWO, there's Stevie Cool. Bizarre Group.
That's Big Stevie Cool, Hollywood, and the Blue Guy, our Velocity.
The following contest is a six-man tag team match scheduled for one fall. Approaching the ring at a combined weight of 720 pounds, the Blue Meanie, Big Stevie Cool, and Hollywood Nova, the Blue World Order. And at 625 pounds, Nick Burke, Jason Static, and Scott Lauer.
You know, Josh, if you take a look at the Blue Beanie close-up, I think he's got a chicken leg bone tucked behind his ear. It still has the crumbs on it. Maybe the blue guy gets hungry during his match and he wants to have a little chicken.
He just tossed it over here by the announce table, believe it or not.
I guess he's not that hungry.
For those of you who don't know who we are, to my right is Hollywood Nova. To my left is none other than the Blue Guy. And of course, I am Big Stevie Cool. And Mexicals, turn off your Juan Deere tractors and pay attention, because this right here is an example of what we're going to do to you at the Great American Bash. And just like you, we're not Mexicans. We're the BWO. And we're taking over.
Well, Josh, BWO wants to take over. The Mexicools say they're taking over SmackDown. We just found out about this match. It will be BWO and the Mexicools at the Great American Bash.
Yeah, you can see how the BWO challenged the Mexicools on WWE.com. That match is now official. A huge six-man tag team match at the Great American Bash. The Mexicools and the BWO. I don't know who to cheer for. I like the Mexicools a lot, but I'm also partial to the BWO. Do you think Nick Patrick is in the BWO? He's got a blue shirt on.
Yeah, he does. Hollywood Nova showing us his backside. That was attractive.
Well, this is Nick Burke in the ring with Hollywood Nova. I guess we'll see how the BWO fares against their competitors now. Maybe we'll get a glimpse of how the BWO is going to work at the Great American Bash.
A tune-up, a warm-up match apparently for the BWO, but let's see what this trio of Burke, Static, and Fowler bring to the table tonight.
Of course, the BWO, a part of ECW, and now they are here on SmackDown in the WWE, and the BWO claim that they're taking over, as you just heard, and the Mexicools claim they're taking over. We'll see at the Great American Bash which one of these groups is really taking over.
We'll certainly see it. And Josh, you know, a match that I know you're looking forward to, we touched upon it briefly, a broad panties match between Melina and Tori Wilson.
I'd like to touch both of their briefs.
That's pretty good. Well, you know, we also saw Candice Michelle in the ring. She will be the special guest referee, and we're seeing the blue guy in here right now. Candice Michelle had blue broad panties on when Tori Wilson and Melina got this big melee in the ring. Melina tore off Candice Michelle's clothes. That was nice as well.
Yeah, Candice Michelle, she's going to be the special guest referee for this broad panties match. But you know what? Who's going to argue with seeing her in her broad panties? I want to see everyone in their broad panties.
Everybody's a winner.
Except for the blue guy.
Yeah, I think that usually, you know, you kind of insert my name there. I'm kind of glad that the blue guy was in the ring.
You know what I'm thinking, too? The ropes are also blue.
Oh, there you go.
So you think the ring is in the BWO?
I don't know, man.
You know, SmackDown. SmackDown's blue.
Yeah, it is. What's his blue gimmick?
Blue and silver.
Ooh. Atomic drop by the Blue Meanie off the ropes. Bulldog, and that's a big man coming down.
Maybe the BWO really is taking over.
I believe that's Jason Static, and certainly getting some from the Blue Meanie. The tag made, Big Stevie Cool now in the ring with the side headlock, and he probably gets the sidewalk slam.
High and tight right there by Jason Static. I wonder what it was like growing up with the last name Static as a kid.
I don't know. I think, like, socks clung to him when he went to school.
I don't think so.
No, static clank.
Oh, no, I get it.
Suplex to Big Stevie Cool, and Nick Burke doing a great job right now. Scott Fowler now in the ring with Big Stevie Cool.
Scott Fowler better stay inside when it's a windy day out. He might get blown away.
Yeah, a bit thin. Right now inflicting damage on Big Stevie Cool and holding his own.
I'm sure the Mexicools are watching this match as they prepare to take on the BWO at the Great American Bash. The Mexicools with the Juice, Hoovy, Super Crazy, and of course Psychosis. We saw Super Crazy in action this past
week. We did.
Point.
Cover on Big Stevie Cool, just a one count. Match against Rey Mysterio.
That's right, Rey Mysterio preparing to take on Eddie Guerrero at the Great American Bash. Had to face Super Crazy on SmackDown, and Rey Mysterio, I believe all his attention is ready and set for Eddie Guerrero.
I'll tell you what, Static came down awkwardly on his neck, and he makes his way out of the ring. Nick Burke now in. That was dangerous.
Oh, this is Hollywood Nova, one-third of the BWO. Kind of wrestles like somebody. I can't put my finger on it.
Yeah, me neither. A double headbutt here. Oh! And Fowler, the tall, thin man, out of the ring.
Big boot!
The big boots. You know, who does he remind me of, Josh?
I can't quite put my finger on it. But this Hollywood Nova, he's got something.
Leg dropped in the tag to the Blue Meanie. Nick Burke, writhing in pain.
Stevie kick!
Catching Static perfectly. And the Big Blue Meanie has gotten to the top rope. The backflip and the cover. Tremendous flexibility.
Here are the winners, the Blue World Order.
The BWO picks up the victory. You know, another new superstar coming is Frankie Kazarian, Josh. And you just spoke to him recently.
Yes, I did. Earlier today, I had an opportunity to talk to Frankie Kazarian. I'm standing here with one of the newest superstars in the WWE, Frankie Kazarian. Frankie, last week, right here on Velocity, you were successful in your debut match in the WWE, defeating Nunzio. Now, it has just been announced that later tonight, you'll go one-on-one with Scotty Too Hottie.
Scotty Too Hottie. I'm wrestling Scotty Too Hottie.
Yeah, that's right.
The guy with the goofy outfits and the worm, he's still wrestling?
Yeah, he's still wrestling.
Dude, I used to watch him like 8 years ago. It's time to change things up around here. It's time for the future of wrestling to take over, and the future is now. So everyone out there, they can cancel their plans on Saturday night, because the future, Frankie Kazarian, has arrived.
Welcome back to Velocity, and Josh, I think it's fair to say that Frankie Kazarian, after one match, thinks he's in. I don't know.
Frankie Kazarian fully confident that he is the future of sports entertainment.
Following contest is scheduled for one fall, approaching the ring from Westbrook, Maine, weighing in at 208 pounds, Scotty Too Hottie.
One thing that never changes, Josh, is the popularity of Scotty Too Hottie. Not only the groovy tune, but, you know, the crowd loves him.
Did you just say groovy tune?
Groovy tune, dude.
Okay, just making sure.
Separate the age difference. You know, nobody can really tell when you see us.
Yeah, right!
Speaking of Frankie Kazarian.
And weighing in at 200 pounds, the future, Frankie Kazarian.
People often ask me, Ski Romero, how I got so lucky to work with my grandfather on Velocity.
I'm speechless. I don't know what to say. You know what? Sometimes when you're older, it takes a while to comprehend the material that you're throwing out. I got to die to the synapses haven't been firing.
Frankie Kazarian is fully focused. He's young. He's ready to go. He's the future of sports entertainment. And if you don't believe me, just ask him. Thanks for taking the words out of my mouth,
Steve Romero. The other thing is,
unbelievable.
Hey, you know what the other thing is?
Why?
He's undefeated.
He's had one match.
He's undefeated.
I'm undefeated on SmackDown, and I've had two matches.
That's a good point. I don't know if I would have drawn that comparison, but thank you for pointing it out.
You're welcome.
Scotty Too Hotty, Frankie Kazarian. Kazarian with a nice toss, and you know what? There it is. There's that cockiness, that brashness that Frankie Kazarian is bringing to Velocity in SmackDown.
Never thought I'd say this, but I miss Rene Dupree.
Boy, really?
I think so. This guy Frankie Kazarian is a little much to handle.
You know, speaking of brashness and cockiness, you know, we see it week in and week out on SmackDown, Josh, but JBL over the top, completely obtuse and obnoxious on SmackDown, throwing a pre-celebration for himself, saying that he will, in fact, guaranteed, in fact, victory over Batista.
Oh, more so than that, JBL made the entire SmackDown about him, and it was all about JBL. JBL's so cold, my God.
Ooh, Frank Kazarian up and over the top rope by Scotty Too Hotty.
Right into your living room, or your bedroom, or your kitchen, wherever you watch Velocity.
Right in front of our announce table, I do know that.
Three, four.
Yeah, so you're saying JBL is a bit selfish. I mean, the confetti, the whole Uncle Sam gimmick that he was dressed up in, come on.
Well, you're going to see it here on Velocity, JBL's victory speech for a match that hasn't even happened yet at the Great American Bash.
Right now, Frankie Kazarian getting done bashing Scotty Too Hotty in the corner, and he will take advantage of it. It does not take him long to learn.
Frankie Kazarian full of moxie here on Velocity. He's ready to go.
You know, speaking of JBL, not only will JBL be in action, his chief of staff, Orlando Jordan, will defend the United States Championship against perhaps one of the toughest competitors in the WWE, the Rabid Wolverine, Chris Benoit.
This will be Orlando Jordan's toughest challenge to date for the United States Championship. The Rabid Wolverine, Chris Benoit, in my opinion, is leaving the Great American Bash, the new United States Champion. And Frankie Kazarian just missed big time.
He may need an ice pack for his onions because he was caught some serious air there. Came down on nothing. Scotty Too Hotty saw it coming. And a big right hand by Scotty. And another. Scotty Too Hotty with a tremendous counter, Josh.
And now Scotty with a nip up of his own. Scotty Too Hotty firing on all cylinders.
Clothesline by Scotty Too Hotty. Right now, Frankie Kazarian wondering where he is at. Big back body drop by Scotty Too Hotty, who's now in control.
Well, Frankie Kazarian was successful last week in his WWE debut against Nunzio. Maybe Frankie Kazarian won't be as lucky here against Scotty Too Hotty.
Scotty Too Hotty with a bit of blood on his lower lip came into the corner, and Frankie with a thumb to the eye takes advantage of it and rips Scotty Too Hotty right into that ring post.
That is solid steel. That hurts on your shoulder. You don't believe me? Go ram yourself into some steel and see how it feels.
That could snap a collarbone in a heartbeat. Kazarian!
That's a single-arm DDT right on that shoulder, and that'll be enough
for Kazarian. You know what that is? That's it. That's the match. The count to three, Kazarian.
Here's your winner, the future, Frankie Kazarian.
Well, Josh, he's brash. He's obnoxious, perhaps cocky. So far in two matches here on Velocity, he's backed it up.
Frankie Kazarian, despite his egotisticalness, that's a word.
It is done now.
Frankie Kazarian gets it done in the ring.
We could have Josh's word of the day.
I think you're right.
That's good. I like that. We'll start next week.
I want a full-page graphic.
It's all about you. Just like JBL.
And I have just proved why I am the future! And the future looks good!
Well, there it is, Josh. Frankie, the future Kazarian.
He's the future, and the future looks good. Oh, I get it.
Up next,
I guarantee you that each and every one of you, I will beat Batista!
Everyone knows JBL has the biggest ego in the WWE, and JBL took his confidence to all new levels, giving a victory speech before the match against Batista at the Great American Bash.
I guarantee that at the Great American Bash, just like last year, I guaranteed victory, and I delivered at the Great American Bash in Buffalo, New York this Sunday. I guarantee, mark my words, put it down, my reputation is at stake. I guarantee you, to each and every one of you, I will beat Batista. He will learn there are legends, there are Hall of Famers, there are all-time greats, but there is one and only one wrestling God.
How do you guarantee victory against this guy? How? Wow! Man, he ever crashed the party.
Now you call yourself a great American. You call yourself a wrestling god! You're neither. I'm gonna tell you what you are, and I'm gonna tell you to your face. You're a liar. You're a loudmouth. You're a bully. And you are a phony. And this Sunday, at the Great American Bash, I'm gonna expose your ass. Last week, you took a cheap shot at me. You took a cheap shot at me. Now you've got the nerve, to come out here and guarantee a victory? Wearing that? Well, I got a little guarantee for you. I guarantee you, in about 2 seconds, I'm gonna whip your ass.
Something's just a few. Here we go!
Batista and JBL exchanging blows. The champion with the right hand.
Well, JBL is not getting the better end of the blow. He's just got beat out. Watch out!
Yeah, Batista steps on the jump from the head.
Watch out!
JBL is hometown. What nothing to do with the champion. On Sunday, he's gonna have no choice.
Batista told JBL is a liar, a loudmouth, a bully, and a phony, and he's going to expose him this Sunday. But...
Oh. That's what Batista thinks of the magazine cover.
Batista split up and cut his eye, and he was kicked at JBL.
Now there's a true American. Sunday, will Batista's title reign continue? Will it be celebration time? Will JBL write another chapter in his impressive championship history?
Well, there's your Great American call right there.
Who will leave the Great American Bash as the World Heavyweight Champion?
JBL is banking on a repeat performance at the Bash, but the former champion will have to take down the fully evolved Animal Batista in order to leave the Great American Bash the World's Heavyweight Champion.
Josh, I mean, unbelievable. It'd be the Road Warrior Animal and Heidenreich teaming up against MNM at the Great American Bash.
A Road Warrior Animal and Hydrax looked impressive this past week on SmackDown, picking up the victory with the Legion of Doom's patented Doomsday device. It'll be shocking if M&M can retain their titles. That's what I said. Shocking if M&M wins.
Well, look at the size difference. Unbelievable.
The tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. Approaching the ring from Los Angeles, California, at a combined weight of 440 pounds, they are the tag team champions, Mercury, Nitro, and Melina, M&M.
Wow. She looks absolutely outstanding tonight, Josh. I know M&M as a group is the feature, but wow.
What? Did you say something, Steve Mount?
I'm trying to learn English right now. I'm almost speechless. Believe that. Smoking hot to the touch, baby. Woo! Josh, wake up.
Huh?
Hello, are you all right?
Oh, yeah, I'm good.
God, you're in a trance there for a minute. I'm like She-Ra, Queen of the Jungle or something.
Man, that Melina. And we might see Melina in her bra and panties at the Great American Bash. My dream may come true.
What a great country this is. Ooh, opponent time.
And at a combined weight of 417 pounds, Danny Dory and Roadkill.
Flashback to ECW days. Josh is just broken. Looks like a Quaker.
Well, I don't know too much about his financial background, but Danny Doring and Roadkill were the last ECW tag team champions. They are now here in the WWE looking to make an impact. And what an opportunity against M&M, the WWE tag team champions.
And Roadkill's a scary look to him. He is a Quaker. He's a bit off. M&M tested before the Great American Bash, where they will really run into some size. Heidenreich and Animal. Really, Josh, when's the last time you were calling a match where the underdog may be favored?
I don't think I ever have. And at the Great American Bash, Road Warrior Animal, one half of the most dominant tag team in the history of sports entertainment, the Road Warriors, teams up with Heidenreich and with Animal's experience, especially in tag team wrestling. They are the favorite.
You know, in M&M, doing what they're doing and doing what they do very well, they cheat to begin the match, pulling hair, coming in, you know, double-teaming Roadkill. That's kind of the thing they're going to have to do at the Great American Bash, even to survive against Heidenreich and Animal.
Well, don't forget, M&M won the WWE Tag Team titles by defeating Eddie Guerrero and Rey Mysterio, and this was the tail end of Eddie and Rey's friendship. I mean, they were already deteriorating, and M&M just jumped on a tremendous opportunity. Now M&M will have to prove themselves at the Great American Bash.
Sidewalk slam, and the cover! The count to two, and Nitro able to kick out. Yeah, that, Josh, that was a team that was completely in disarray, speaking of Eddie and Rey. Heidenreich and Animal on the same page, maybe a force to be reckoned with. The cover here, count to two as well.
That's Danny Doring in the ring right now.
Don't let the spin park sparkles fool you, huh?
Now, Danny Doring can definitely go inside the ring.
Tag made and going downstairs, and then a couple right hands. Mercury having at it.
You don't mess with me. We're the champs.
Well, for now, M&M are the champions, but will they be at the Great American Bash after their match with Heidenreich and his new friend, Road Warrior Animal?
Oh, atomic drop, inverted atomic drop, and then the drop kick follows. Danny Doring making a great move in the cover. The count to two. Right now, M&M with their hands full, Josh.
Well, I tried to speak to M&M earlier. They just kind of blew me off.
Ooh, the roll up here by Doring. And that didn't last long.
And Eminem told me before they blew me off that they'll take out all challengers. They don't care. And then they walked away from me. I tried to talk to Melina, and she walked away too.
Did you? I mean, they realize this is Josh Matthews they're talking to, and they had the nerve to walk off?
You know, they got Melina, so I think they can do whatever they want.
Yeah, you know, that's a good point.
If I had Melina, I wouldn't even be here. I'd be somewhere else.
Oh, neck breaker on Dory by like Mercury.
Magic Mountain.
You know, you're partial to mountains. I'm kind of partial with the sunrise.
Maybe we'd be playing PlayStation.
PlayStation? I was thinking maybe breakfast. Sunrise and breakfast.
What the hell are you talking about?
I don't know.
Here comes Roadkill.
The Quaker. I mean Roadkill.
Roadkill making Mercury look just like Roadkill.
And he is a big man and a power slam there.
You can see that Roadkill's definitely got size, but he's also got speed as well.
Big back body drop to Nitro. Right now, the tag team champs in disarray.
Nitro better watch out.
Ooh. Roadkill with a slam, like a cross body, then up over the top rope, but he then runs into the boot of Mercury. Cross body by Mercury, that does not work whatsoever.
He got caught.
Veteran move, the tag, the slam, and now Doring up to the top rope. The leg drop doesn't work.
Well, Danny Doring went for pay dirt and missed his opportunity. Snapshot.
And when you're a challenger, you can't miss your opportunity because this happens. Eminem takes advantage of the opportunity, Josh. The snapshot is there, and there it is. Get her to wear this outfit again sometime.
I certainly hope so. Eminem has the tag team titles for now. Will they have them at the Great American Bash?
A great card at the Great American Bash. I cannot wait. He's Josh Matthews. I'm Steve Romero. We'll talk to you next week.